up, guys? 33 and a third RPM here, back today to do another album review at the wall. Haven't said that in a long time. Today, we're covering a pretty special album to me. I think this guy is really something special. His first mixtape is the bomb. His second album, Blonde, is amazing. But I think today we're talking about his magnum opus. This is Frank Ocean's 2012 project, Channel Orange. Channel Orange is a little weird for me how I got into it. I remember seeing this album or hearing it for the first time at the Grammys when Frank performed the now infamous performance of Forrest Gump, where the audio didn't work and the screen was a little off sync and his piano, it just wasn't great. But I remember being so intrigued by that song and it stuck with me. And I, you know, now that I've gotten to the point where I make my own music tastes and stuff, I revisited this album a couple years later after that, and I fell in love with it. There are so many things to like in this album, from Frank's fantastic voice, to the awesome lyrics, to even how he utilizes guest spots on here. There's so many great guests. Even though there is only three people on here, they're all fantastic. This is an awesome album. So, let's talk about what makes this album work. It has fantastic shifts in mood, and you're gonna say, that sounds really weird, but it's true. Almost every song on here is a different tone, be it slightly depressing, upbeat, more relaxed, or just insane off the charts. Crazy. And yet, it doesn't feel jarring, ever. It feels like every song naturally transitions to one another, and that's because of the loose concept in this. Now, it's not a concept record, there's no big story that goes between this, but you'll notice at the beginning and the ends of some songs there's maybe a little bit of static or some clicks or something, and that's because this entire thing is supposed to be a radio show. Someone's flicking through the radio and hearing all these different programs, which are the songs. You know, the songs start and end, which are respectively the first and last tracks on here, have ambient noises of people talking, cell phones ringing, cars starting, and set up this mood of you get in the car with your friends, turn on the radio, here's what you hear. And that's why, for me, the transition from songs like, oh, I don't know, Monks to Bad Religion, or Pink Matter to Forrest Gump, or, you know, they don't feel jarring. I'm like, oh, what was that? That's a weird thing to lead into. It just flows really nice. Now, like I hinted at, there are upbeat songs on here. Songs like Lost, the verses, I'd say, of Super Rich Kids. Sweet Life and Forrest Gump are all super catchy songs. Sweet Life having this awesome backing track that pushes Frank's chorus to the next level, and his verses are a little more quiet as he sings about living the sweet life and the mangoes, peaches, and limes. Songs like Forrest Gump sound almost like they were influenced by some sort of house track with these synths that overlay the entire song as he sings about Forrest Gump, about the movie Forrest Gump, the plotline of the movie. Songs like Lost, this album does have a lot of lyrical content, some great lines, but this song just says, well, let's have fun with this, and makes a song that's really happy over this bouncing synth tone that, you know, still has a little bit of those hints of depression about being lost in the world that the rest of this album has. You know, there are some downers on here, but they're all fantastically executed. Songs like Bad Religion, Pink Matter, even to an extent, songs like Crack Rock and Sierra Leone and Thinking About You, which is not depressing, but it's a very quiet song, all are beautiful, whether it's Frank's falsetto on the song I just mentioned, Thinking About You in the chorus, which is so strong, or the out-of-nowhere incredible Andre 3000 verse on Pink Matter. It just, it fits a lot of different moods, and I think that's what this album really achieves well, is jumping back and forth between all these different genres and doing all of them perfectly. Now, like I said before, the guests on this album, there's only three of them, but they're all utilized amazingly. The first one on here is on track 7, Super Rich Kids. That's Earl Sweatshirt. He's fellow ex-Odd Future member with Frank, and man, this is a great verse from Earl. Earl has always had a knack for lyricism and just a really unique flow, but this song really feels like he kicked it up to the next level, especially with that thumping piano line in the background that goes through the entire track and his almost bored sounding flow that goes with the song of being bored out of your mind because you're so rich, you have everything, but at the same time you still have problems like depression and suicide. Second guest on here is on the track White. The guest is John Mayer, and he plays electric guitar, and it is awesome. It's only about a minute long, but it creates this nice sense of ambience that goes through this entire record. And then the last one is, like I said, Andre 3000 on the track Pink Matter. Now, Andre comes out of nowhere and drops two killer verses, and the first time I heard this, he appears at the very end, and I went, is that Andre? Andre 3000? Like, from Outkast. And it transitions so quickly to the next song, Forrest Gump, that I had to stop. I had to lift the needle and go, is that Andre? It's awesome. It's not like he sounds any different. I just wasn't expecting it. He's not credited on the back of the album. Look, here's Pink Matter. You can see White has John Mayer. Pink Matter doesn't have Andre 3000. I was like, first time I heard this, crazy. These guests all fit the tone of their songs perfectly, whether it be kind of the trippy, spaced out feel of Pink Matter, the relaxed vibe of White, fueled by John Mayer's guitar playing, or as I talked about before, Earl Sweatshirt's incredible flow. They all work really well. Now, there are a couple intermissions slash skit things on this album. We have the songs Fertilizer, the Start song, just called Start's the first song, Not Just Money, White, and then the End song, End. These are all little intermissions, with Fertilizer being obviously the best one because it's so catchy. Only 40 seconds long, but has one of the best lines in the entire album. Fertilizer, I'll take bullshit if that's all you got, over this bouncing synth line that sounds like almost a TV ad for something. It's awesome. Once again, going back to that radio theme. They never feel like a chore to listen to, like, oh man, this is getting in the way of the next song, because they're so creative and so different and so catchy. They're awesome. One of my favorites is also the End song on here, just titled End, which actually contains a sample of Frank's own stuff. He took one of his songs called Voodoo, it was never on one of his albums, just kind of put it out there, took the first verse, cut it in half, put a ton of vocal effects over it, washed in and out half of the song with synths and bleeps so you can't understand what he's saying in this very spacey sound, which is awesome. And, you know, the words that do become clear through this kind of fog of lyrics is, looks like all we got is each other, the truth is obsolete, and she's got the whole wide world in her juicy fruit, which is just never fails to make me smile every time I listen to it. This is just a very, very unique and special album. So let's look and see what's in this thing. We got Channel Orange, There Is Nothing on the Spine, it's just all orange. We got the tracks on the back, like I showed you before, with some times on there, which is kind of cool. Not a lot of people do that. This is a double album. First one here is, I really love the colors on this. It's cool because they're different colors, despite being the same like record. Like they're both different. You'll see. This is White. I love these labels. They're almost minimalist with this kind of like play slash eject logo on there and in the tracks. It's a little bit milky white, like there's some sort of webbing holding this together. It's pretty cool. But that's not the reason I love this. The second album, or the second record is, side C and D. Now, I have a couple clear records, but this might be one of my favorite colors ever. This is a magenta record. I think this is just beautiful. I love this label. Once again, doesn't change, it's the same thing. But I love this color. I think this is so cool. It is translucent, although it isn't transparent. It's cool. So Frank is kind of a myth in the music industry, you know. He disappeared after making this album and winning a couple Grammys, and normally, you know, he disappeared for 4 years, deleted his social media, and made Blonde, you know, while he was working on that, but I think that he could do that for this album, because it is that special, and it is that great. You know, 17 songs, and they're all awesome. If you notice, there's one song I didn't talk about yet, save it to the end, it's Pyramids. Pyramids is awesome. Pyramids is Frank Ocean firing on all cylinders. It's broken up into these three energetic chunks of songs. The first one being about Frank singing about this Egypt in turmoil as Cleopatra the queen has been killed. There's assassins, nightlife, snakes are crawling into people's beds and killing them. it just sounds intense. This is broken up by this awesome synth melody that sounds like Daft Punk made it. Then he flips the entire story onto its head and changes the pyramids of Egypt into the pyramids of Las Vegas and then into a strip club. And Cleopatra is now a stripper going there, and he talks about the atmosphere that he sees and the lifestyle of these people. And it's awesome. It's 9 minutes long, but it never feels like I'm listening to a 9 minute track. I never get to this song on the album and go, I'm gonna have to be here for 9 minutes listening to the same synth tone. No, it's awesome. It's one of the few songs that I'll go my way to listen to that's 9 minutes long. Like, how many songs do you want to sit down and listen to for that long? This one is awesome. So yeah, this is, like I said before, this is my favorite R&B album. I love this album so much, which is why I'm gonna do it. I just give this album a 10 out of 10. I think this album is perfect. One of the classics of our generation. If you haven't heard before, definitely go check it out. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you like Frank Ocean, if you like Channel Orange, if you're ice cold, leave me a comment below. Let's talk about this album. I love talking about this album. Also, if you made it to the end, comment Mangoes, Peaches, and Limes, because why not? But until next time, guys, I'm 33 and a third RPM. Keep on spinning. I'll catch you on the flip side.